underway. Day two of the hike. Come from back up there. There's the Grand Combine. Weather's holding right now. It's a little overcast, but what do we find by the side of the trail? A kennel of what appears to be huskies. And they're being fed. It's feeding time. Yeah, those are huskies and alcans. Bonjour. So we're moving along here. There's our destination, the Col Termine in Louvry. One thing to look at is this here. That's the Alpine symbol, the European Alpine symbol. What that means is that we are on what is known as an Alpine route, which means possible dangerous conditions. Mostly here because of rockfall. That's the valley. That's where we came from yesterday, down there somewhere, even further down in that valley than we're looking now. We came from back up there to the right. I'm just doing this again because I don't know if I was filming just a second ago. That is where we have to go. I'm just getting my breath back. We just came up with a pretty tough section. We just came up that ravine. We crossed that ravine. Let's see where the trail goes over there. Magnificent views. Few clouds starting to gather around the Combine. We expect it'll be rain later, maybe later tonight. So hopefully we won't get stuck in it. But we'll be off this exposed section in less than an hour, hopefully. That'd be good news, although it's great views. Right, Liv?
It's great.
It was admonishing me to get to a safe place to film them. There's a group of about four chamois down there. And we heard some rock fall in here, and maybe that's what we were hearing. Yeah. Oh, there they are. I gotta get into them. All right. Actually a fairly good trail, so I'm gonna video here. We just came through a section of a really awful trail. You can see the stone below us. There's a group of chamois, like deer, on the ridge, on the stone fall, and they were moving, and you could hear the stones just sliding around. They were kicking loose. Unbelievable. This is one hell of a trail.
Pretty good
section of trail here. Wow, that landslide zone. So far the weather's held.
So far.
There's the Col Termine, dead ahead. Right there. We've been waiting to see that, because that's our first checkpoint. Great views, but this is a somewhat concerning trail, to say the least. So, we're here in the Col Termine. As you can see, it's a formidable looking place. Strange news, strange tidings. We are all set to just go on to our next destination, which is two more coals from here. That was a hard hike in. That was hard. And we met a girl coming back this way, and she was with the hut people from down there. Down there you will see a lake called Lake Lac de Louvry, I think, and there's a cabin down there. And she's like, you know, it'll be a lot better. It'll be very hard if you go on to the Cabane de Plofori, which is where we were going to go. That is the route. But she said, oh, that'll make it a decent day if you go down there. And I think I'm being seduced by the dark side of the force, and the reason being is, well, gosh, take a look. I mean, we're probably going to be hiking at least another 6 hours in that, and I don't know if I can do it, frankly. I mean, just flat out, I'm not sure if I haven't bitten off too much here, more than I can chew. That was a hell of a hike. I feel great. Sylvia's feeling good. But we had some dicey moments there. There was some dicey moments. We're heading down into this bowl of land that is the Grand Desert. It's ahead of us. There's where we're trying to get to, is that cabin right there. See if I can get it in for you. I just slid down on my butt on some gravel. And there's a dam in the background. One of the dams. And what we're going to try and do is get a room there. We were going on to cross another two coals, but it's not going to happen. We're going to ground there, and if we can't get someplace there, the valley's an hour and a half away from there.
So what we're going through here, all we're trying to do, we're now off the hot rod route trail. All we're trying to do is to get down to a lake on the right, which seemed very close at hand from the coal, where there's a hut that we can probably get accommodations in. It was listed as an hour and 10 minutes away. To get down here, it's like crossing the summit cone of Mount Washington. I mean, it's all blasted rock as far as the eye can see. So we're obviously reappraising our what we're going to be doing.
This place, we just came down that. And it was not easy. There's a little, it's kind of a raptor chasing other birds over there. Falcon maybe? Oh, Harrier. See it?
That one?
Yeah. Well, maybe a falcon. It could be a falcon. Yeah, he's moving fast. Fast on the dive right there. That might have been a falcon. Anyway, we're heading for the cabin, which is over there. One gentleman passed us. He's down there. I don't know where he came from. But other than that, we have seen, I think, a grand total of 6 people on this entire route. And this is a dismal, forbidding place. Yeah. There's just not a lot of comfy in this place right here. It is magnificent, but this is a very, very isolated coal. There are farms and villages within just a few miles of here, but they might as well be in another country. They're way over those walls. Very nice little series of waterfalls here coming down this bleak valley. I have no idea what this place is, but I know where, if we keep scrolling the camera down, I know where this water's going. Down these little cascades down that way. That is the Lac de Louvre. And that set of peaks there is the Grand Combine. The main peak is in the clouds. And you see there's a bridge down there. The hut is actually, you can't see it, but it's, actually you can see it. It's right there above the lake. So we'll probably be there in 25 minutes, 20 minutes, something like that.
There we go.
Gardo.
What?
What?
Far.
It looks far. It's not that far. We're going to be there soon. We are in our bedroom, which is a dormitory room. Great view of the Grand Combine outside the Cabine de Louvre. What do you think, Liv?
That's a good one.
There's our bunk that I almost fell off of just a moment ago. In Europe, they have tiger moths, not hummingbirds. No, tiger moths. Get to the hut we wanted to get to, but this one has a heck of a view. Combi massive. Take a look at this flag here. Did you see this thing?
It's a golden flag.
I hope they're married, is all I'm gonna say. Look at this beautiful lake in a ravine. Towering glacial ravine. Towering ravine.